Opposition coalition Isambayan will announce its list of potential bets for the 2022 elections on June 12th. That's Independence Day. Isambayan co-convener lawyer Howard Calleja says the list of nominees for president, vice president, and senators will be posted online. The public will be allowed to vote for their preferred candidates. Calleja says the result of the online poll will be the basis for their final list of candidates.
Among the choices, I said we have about 5 to 7 names na ilalagay doon for position of president and vice president. Mm-hmm. And about, in my last count, about 20 names that we would look, we would place as choices for the positions of 12 senators for next election. So gusto po namin marinig ang pulso ng mamamayang Pilipino.
A former official from the Information and Communications Technology Department alleges government's free public Wi-Fi initiative was grossly overpriced. Retired Brigadier General and electronics engineer Eliseo Rio claims some half a billion pesos in pandemic emergency funds were needlessly spent for a project that should have cost far less. RG Cruz tells us more.
Former Department of Information and Communication Technology Undersecretary Eliseo Rio accuses government of wasting Bayanihan funds in its bid to provide free Wi-Fi project in public places. Speaking before the inquiry of the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability, Rio claimed the cost of the current project was overpriced by about half a billion pesos. Rio adds the same project, in partnership with the United Nations Development Program, could have done that project at a cheaper price. It was the former undersecretary who spearheaded the Free Wi-Fi for All project before he stepped down from his post last year. Rio likewise pointed out that the DICT did not hold a public bidding for the contracts they awarded for the project, which was done through negotiated contracts, adding that government is also shortchanged since any new equipment needed for the project stays with the service providers. Rio notes that compared to the DICT-UNDP project, all awards were overpriced almost 5 times, an allegation dismissed by Information and Communication Undersecretary Manny Cahintic.
Hindi po totoo na overpriced, Mr. Chair, for the price of the internet that we are providing now, mas substantially, mas maganda ang magiging user experience po ng mga tao. So it is 10 times more cheaper yung ating per bandwidth na per Mbps.
But Rio, who also led the country's search for a third telco player, fired back.
Mr. Cahintic, he's not a telco man, sir. He has no license in electronic communication engineering. He may not know that VSAT is limited in speed, no? I mean, you cannot put in so many megabits. Yung sinasabi niya, yung mga pwedeng ilagay doon, okay, you know, kung fiber talaga ang nakakabit doon, no? Pag VSAT, I've been with the armed forces, we've been using VSAT. Eh, maganda na ako kung makakuha tayo ng about 2 megabits. And this VSAT are placed in very remote areas.
The committee will resume its investigation next week. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.